Our short film of happenings at St Michael's commence in the early days of Paul Drake's time as our vicar. Like the villagers and his predecessors, he was proud of St Michael's.
Well, St Michael's is one of only three unspoilt parochial churches of the Norman period that have not been added to, or beautified, or made more magnificent in the Gothic era.
In 1971, Tony Greenslade's camera caught Paul Drake in action on two occasions. The first was a visit by the pipe-smoking Bishop of Buckingham. The choir is led by Robert Healy, carrying the cross. He was the son of Stewkley schoolteacher Bessie Healy. Here the Bishop is greeted at the door of St Michael's by the church wardens, Bill Grace and Frank Main. Not only church wardens, but the patriarchs of the time of two Stewkley families who could, and still can, trace their ancestry back in local records for more than five centuries. After the service, the bishop met the locals. Earlier, I described him as a pipe-smoking bishop. Well, here he proves that. On Remembrance Day, following the choir, church ministers and the Royal British Legion Colour Party are the Girl Guides, Scouts, Brownies and Cups. All good things come to an end. It was 1985 when the parish said goodbye to Paul Drake and his wife Rosemary. Church treasurer John Gallimore was the man to say thank you.
Well, I hardly know where to begin when trying to thank Paul for his service as our vicar over the last 15 years.
Next was the presentation by the Reverend Dick Howard. Mrs. Drake received flowers. Then, like a footballer showing off a cup, the departing vicar presented his cup and very nearly lost the lid. And on behalf of the youth of the church, there were thank yous. First, from Andrew Carter.
We'd like to give the vicar this picture for all the support and encouragement he's given us since the group was formed.
Then from Susan Siddons on the right and Karen Jopling. Paul Drake said a few words, but the camera recorded only a few seconds of the dancing which followed.